السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، اللهم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم، ولا فهم لنا إلا ما فهمتنا إنك أنت الجواد الكريم. اللهم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربي زدني علما، اللهم ربنا زدنا علما، اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. اللهم اجعل اجتماعنا هذا اجتماعا مرحوما، وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا ولا معنا شقيا ولا محروما، آمين يا رب العالمين. وبعد، my dear respected brothers, elders and sisters in Islam, alhamdulillah thumma alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us again to witness the day of Eid al-Adha. And on this important day and this blessed day, we try to go over the story of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Because Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was from those Anbiya who are amongst the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, were kept in the high regard, Ulul Azm. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, from the very early on in his life, from the very beginning in his life, he was tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one after the other. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was a very young man, and he was very young. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enabled him to have the belief in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when he took the message to his people, and his people were amongst the people who used to do idol worshipping, they used to worship idols, they used to make their own little gods and used to pray to them and ask them for assistance. However, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam with the belief of oneness, he started giving da'wah. And then, very early on, he was disowned by his own people. He used to live in Iraq. He had to migrate from there to Ash-Sham. And the mu'arikhin rahmatullah alayhi, the historian, have said, when he was migrating from his own people to Ash-Sham, by the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there was only two people with him. His wife, Sarah radiallahu anha, and his nephew, Lut alayhi salatu wasalam. And remember, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam came at the time where there were no prophet between him and Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, except two Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, Prophet Salih and Prophet Hud. The ulama says it was a distance between 2,640 years. Almost that period of time, only two Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came. So he left his own people by the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And while he was going, in the way he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, Rabbi habli min as-salihin. Oh Allah, bless me with righteous child. So he will give me the shoulder or the support to take my message and to give da'wah with ease. And this one ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran is a very depth. There's a very depth in it. When Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he could have asked, oh Allah, bless me with a child. But he alayhi salatu wasalam made the dua, Rabbi habli min as-salihin. Oh Allah, bless me with a child, not a normal or regular child, but a child that is righteous, for you and I to follow, that when we ask for children, many of us are married, mashallah. Don't just ask for Allah, bless me with a child, but make this condition or put this in it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Allah, bless me with righteous children. Oh Allah, bless me with righteous children. I was studying in the madrasa. Someone came to my teacher and he used to teach at Tirmidhi Sharif. And he complained that, you know, I was married for so many years, I do not have a child. So my sheikh, my teacher, Mufti Amjad, he told him to read this dua before you say salam in every salah, whether it is first salah or sunnah or nafil. Before you say salam, after durood, at-tahiyyat and durood and dua, then make this a special dua also. Read it three times. Allahumma rabbi habli min as-salihin. Allahumma rabbi habli min as-salihin. Allahumma rabbi habli min as-salihin. And soon, inshallah, you will be blessed with a child. Anyways, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala later on, at the age of 86, when Ibrahim alayhi salam was 86, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with a child named Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam was very beloved to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. He used to give him a good comfort. And when Ibrahim when Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam reached, according to Al-Qurtubi rahimahullah, when he reaches the age of 13, according to Tafsir Al-Mazhari, when he reaches the age of Bulugha, puberty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam with another test. What he said in his dream, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعْيَ قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam sees in his dream that he is slaughtering his own child. And remember, the dreams of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam are a part of wahi. If any of us sees these kind of dreams, we should not fulfill it. Any dream that we see that is against the sunnah or against the sharia, we should not fulfill it. Or if we see these kind of dreams specifically that we are slaughtering our child, we need to go see a doctor, maybe a psychiatrist, to, you know, not to fulfill our dreams anyways. But he, alayhi salatu wasalam, he knew that it was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he discussed his dream. He told his son Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam that I see in the dream that inni ara fil manami anni azbahuk, that I see in my dream that I am slaughtering you. Fanzur ma'adha tara. Then what do you say about that? The ulama ikram rahmatullah alayhi have clearly stated that Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was not asking his child that whether we should fulfill the dream, but rather he was testing his son Ismail. There was an imtihan, there was a test in it. But the son was also a great in terms of his, you know, in his heart, in his character. He said, قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرُ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Oh my father, whatever you have seen in your dream, go ahead and fulfill it. And you will find me amongst the people of Sabirin. I will not say anything against him. And the story continues. He went and he took his son Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam at the maqam of, you know, where we go for Hajj, Mina, Jamarat. And Iblis came to him. He says, do not fulfill your dream. What if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted something else from you? So he threw seven pebbles at him. And then he moved on from there. He went to a different place, few steps ahead, where we do second jamarat, and then the third jamarat. Shaitan came again to put doubts in his intention and not to fulfill this dream. But Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he was firm with his son. And his son was also, you know, he told his father, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, that whenever you would go and fulfill your dream, And you wanted to slaughter me, make sure you lay me on the backside. Take my forehead touching the ground. So Ibrahim, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in this, in the surah, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ. You have to lay me down, you know, on the forehead. So that, you know, you would not see mercy. Because when you see my face, you might change your mind, or the doubts might come. But anyways, he did that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced Ismail alayhi salatu wa salam with a ram. And then he slaughtered the ram. The moral of the story is that from this day, we continue the sunnah to slaughter animal. According to Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi, it is wajib. The qurbani is wajib on every soul, Muslim, aqil and baligh, who possess the nisab of zakat, which is almost $500. If you have that much amount of money, you should and you must fulfill the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam and have an animal sacrifice on your behalf. Inshallah, I will say one or two things in terms of the importance of doing the qurbani. Number one is that make sure if you have a little or young children at home, you take out your time and do the qurbani yourself. At least one qurbani here, so that your children will learn the importance of qurbani and they'll see the blood and discuss the story. I could not go over the story in detail. It's a beautiful story. Teach them, you know, the lessons from the story. That how and why do we sacrifice and we submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our desire must be submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must be upheld and must be held in the high regard. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's hukum comes, we should not do anything against it. Number two, if you are doing qurbani in Pakistan, I will tell you one important thing, inshallah, then I will conclude. Or in any other country, I would not suggest anyone to do internet or online sacrifice or a telephonic sacrifice. Find someone in your own family back home who is struggling. Let it be your cousin, your family member, your brother who do not have enough. Send the money to them and do the qurbani. This way you will get double the reward. You will get the reward of qurbani and you will get the reward of sila rahmi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you with twice as much. So rather than, you know, booking your qurbani online, send the money, ask your parents, if you do not know all your relatives, to someone in your family who is going, you know, going through a hard time or who needs the meat of qurbani, send the money to them. And do not tell them that it's sadaqah, just give them the money. Let them get the best animal, because remember, choosing the best animal is also a part of the deen. In one of the hadiths, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the qurbani, the animal that you sacrifice will become the right for you on the day of Qiyamah on Sirat al-Mustaqim. So choose the best animal, inshallah, on your behalf, whatever you can afford, inshallah. As we promise, we'll conclude on this. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلِسَائِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Start the salah on time, inshallah. Salat al-Eid has six extra takbirat, inshallah. There will be three extra takbirat in first rak'at before the qira'at. And there will be three extra takbirat in second rak'at after the qira'at. In the first rak'at, the imam will say Allahu Akbar, will put his hand back, and then will recite salam, and then there will be Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, three extra takbirat. So you raise your hand, and then let them hang it for the first and the second one. For the third one, put your hands together and then you can recite, you can follow the imam, he will recite al-Fatiha and the surah. In the third raka'ah, imam will recite al-Fatiha and the surah, and then there will be three extra takbirah. So Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. For all three times you will raise our hand and let them hang it. When imam says four times Allahu Akbar, then we will go into ruku' and then we will complete the salah. Three extra takbirah in the first raka'ah, three extra takbirah in the second rak'at, in first rak'at before qira'at, in the second rak'at we'll have after the qira'at, inshallah. And if you do not know, you could forget, just follow someone who is next to you, teach it after the people, inshallah. JazakAllah khair. Allahu Akbar. Subhanakallah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Malik Yawm Al-Din. Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in. Ihdina الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ما كان على النبي من حرج فيما فرض الله له سنة الله في الذين خلوا من قبل وكان أمر الله قدرا مقدورا الذين يبلغون رسالات الله ويخشونه ولا يخشون أحدا إلا الله وكفى بالله حسيبا ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين وكان الله بكل شيء عليما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور وكان بالمؤمنين رحيما تحيتهم يوم يلقونه سلام وأعد لهم أجرا كريما يا أيها النبي إنا أرسلناك شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا وبشر المؤمنين بأن لهم من الله فضلا كبيرا ولا تطع الكافرين والمنافقين ودع أذاهم وتوكل على وكفى بالله وكيلا الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما إن الذين يؤذون الله ورسوله لعنهم الله في الدنيا والآخرة وأعد لهم عذابا مهينا والذين يؤذون المؤمنين والمؤمنات بغير ما اكتسبوا فقد احتملوا بهتانا وإثما مبينا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله 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 أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبيه الكريم سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الحمد لله الذي جعل لكل أمة مسكنا ليذكروا اسم الله على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام وعلم التوحيد وأمر بالسلام. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله الذي هدانا إلى دار السلام. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين قاموا بإقامة الأحكام وبذلوا أنفسهم وأموالهم في سبيل الله، فيا لهم من كرام، وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: ما عمل ابن آدم من عمل يوم النحر أحب إلى الله من إهراق الدم، وإنه ليأتي يوم القيامة بقرونها وأشعارها وأخلافها، وإن الدم ليقع من الله بمكان قبل أن يقع بالأرض فطيب بها نفسه. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. وقال أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: يا رسول الله، ما هذه الأضاحي؟ قال: سنة أبيكم إبراهيم عليه الصلاة والسلام. قالوا: فما لنا فيها يا رسول الله؟ قال: بكل شعرة حسنة. قالوا: فالصوف يا رسول الله؟ قال: بكل شعرة من الصوف حسنة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: من وجد ساعة لأن يضحي فلم يضحي فلا يحضر مصلانا. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. وقال ابن عمر رضي الله عنه: الأضاحي يومان بعد يوم الأضحى، وعن علي مثله. وهذا بعض من الفضائل. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها، ولكن يناله التقوى منكم، كذلك سخرها لتكبروا الله على ما هداكم، وبشر المحسنين. صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الحمد لله الذي كان بعباده خبيرا بصيرا، وتبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا وجعل فيها سراجا وقمرا منيرا، وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة بالقلب واللسان. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، اتقوا الله تعالى حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون، وتوكلوا عليه حق توكله، فإنه من يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه، إن الله بالغ أمره، قد جعل الله لكل شيء قدرا. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. اعلموا أن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه، وثنى بملائكة مسبحة بقدسه، وثلث بكم أيها المؤمنون من جنه وإنسه، فقال قولا كريما: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد. كلما ذكره الذاكرون الأبرار، وكلما غفل عن ذكره الغافلون الأشرار. وبعدد ما في جميع القرآن حرفا حرفا، وبعدد كل حرف ألفا ألفا، وعلى جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين، وعلى الملائكة المقربين والخلفاء الراشدين. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. اللهم ارفع ذنوبنا، واستر عيوبنا، وفرج كروبنا، واكشف همومنا، وأزل غمومنا. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرض المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وموتى المؤمنين. اللهم أيقظ أمتنا من غفلتها، وأحيها من موتتها. اللهم أصلح حكامها وولاتها، اللهم أعد للدين عزه، اللهم أعد للدين مجده، اللهم بارك لنا في علمائنا وانفعنا بعلمهم ونور بصيرتهم وارفع قدرهم، اللهم اجعلهم ممن يقولون الحق وينصرون دينك ولا يخافون لومة لائم، اللهم أعد المسجد الأقصى إلى رحاب المسلمين، اللهم أعد المسجد الأقصى إلى رحاب المسلمين، اللهم ارزقنا فيه صلاة قبل الممات، اللهم طهر المسجد الأقصى من الظالمين المجرمين، اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل دين محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام ولا تجعلنا منهم، آمين يا رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. عيد مبارك، عيد الأضحى مبارك to all of you. I would like to request all the brothers to do a social distancing greetings unless you know someone is vaccinated or someone is from your family, inshallah, then you can greet. جزاكم الله خير. عيد مبارك to all of you.
Yeah, I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it.